here on a busy Sunday afternoon to learn a bit about and be involved in politics across the Commonwealth of Virginia. It's very meaningful to all of us, and I look forward to answering your questions and hearing maybe some of what's on your mind in the community. First of all, I would like to thank you for all that you do for the community, the involvement, and especially for promoting diversity. I think it's fair to say that we live in a very diverse society, and that means, and we've been very proud to uphold these standards. When I say we, our governor, our attorney general, myself, that we want to be inclusive in the Commonwealth of Virginia. We feel that our lights need to be on, our doors open, and so the discrimination and the hatred that we see, a lot of which I think stems from what's going on the other side of the Potomac River, has no place in the Commonwealth of Virginia. So as long as that's the way it will be. I want to bring some good news to you. Despite what we see on the TV sometime or read in the paper, there is a lot of enthusiasm and energy across the Commonwealth of Virginia right now. People are standing up and coming to us and saying, how can we get involved? What can we do to help? And I think the reason for that is because of what we witnessed in 2016, and that was really a campaign that was run off of bigotry and hatred and discrimination and fear and a lot of misinformation. So people are standing up and saying, this is not the United States of America that I believe in. It's not the Commonwealth of Virginia. It's not going to be what we accept as the new normal. So it's incumbent on all of us to harness this energy and make sure that we take it to the polls on Election Day, because as you know, these elections have tremendous, tremendous consequences. Now, as was said, and I certainly appreciate the introduction, I am a pediatrician. I have taken care of sick children and their families for over 25 years. And so one of the things that I like to do is to listen. And I think any good doctor should be a good listener. And so as we travel around the Commonwealth, I'd like to let you know what I hear from people. And the first thing is that they want a job. People want a job that they can support themselves and their families with. That's not asking for too much. They want to make sure that their families have access to affordable and quality health care. And that's something as physicians, we live in the richest country in the world. Nobody, no individual or family should be one medical illness away from financial demise. And that's really where we are. They want to make sure that we live and advocate for a clean environment. That means that things like global warming, and by the way, I am a scientist, I believe in global warming. We pursue other avenues of energy, such as renewable energy, wind, solar. These are very important, and we've made some progress, and I suspect you heard our announcement a couple of days ago in Richmond that we are pursuing renewable energy in Virginia, and so we're very proud of that. And then finally, they want to live in safe communities where there are not guns on every street corner. And so that's something that we have all be in favor of. So I will remind you of one last thing and this is not a Democratic or a Republican issue. It really should be a Virginia issue, and that is gerrymandering. If we're going to have good representation and a good, strong democracy, we really need to support nonpartisan redistricting in the Congress. We will be able to accomplish a lot of these goals. So I thank you for allowing me to be here. Again, it means the world to me to be able to communicate with you. And I look forward to your questions, and I will answer them as best I can. Thank you so much.